You guys ever find yourself lugging an entire suitcase filled with 100,000 zenny, ready to give it up to the person that actually saved the world for which you took credit for? I know you're thinking to yourself, there's gotta be a easier, faster, and more versatile way to carry all this money. If only I had a wallet that actually fit the necessities and fit sleekly into my pocket. Well, today I have some good news for you because this video is sponsored by Ridge Wallets, a wallet that's sure to revolutionize the way you carry money, owing much to its sleek and slender design that fits any pocket, including your front one, holding up to 12 cards plus cash, made with RFID blocking technology that protects you from digital pickpocketers. Ditch the old bulky, awkward wallet filled with receipts, business cards you'll never use, and expired gift cards, and go with a more industrialized design, like my favorite forged carbon, which is made out of the toughest material to protect all that precious cargo inside. Use my code BLACKSCAPE today to get 10% off your Ridge wallet by clicking the link in the description below and the top comment. Use the only wallet that Mr. Hercule supports. Get your Ridge wallet today.
Prepare yourself, Dan Saiyan.
Subscribe and hit the notification bell to help us achieve the 300K mortal plan. Every soul counts. Let me know in the comments below if you guys like the way that Goku defeated Moro. Do you guys like Goku's astral form or Susanoo, what people are calling it essentially? Is that the way that you thought he was going to defeat Moro? Let me know in the comments below what your thoughts are on this. Let's go ahead and jump right in. So Toyotaro has definitely more than likely read Dragon Ball Shippuden. Now, if you don't know what Dragon Ball Shippuden is, it is a series that I covered here on the channel, long-running series, but it is by far my favorite Dragon Ball fan manga that I've ever covered. I have a whole playlist. I'm gonna leave a link to it in the description below. Go ahead and check it out. But essentially what it is the most believable version of Goku being transported into the Naruto world. I'm a huge Naruto fan, so much so that I have a tattoo of the curse mark on my back because Naruto is one of the best anime series, one of the best series of anything that I've ever seen. So that's why I so much attach myself to Dragon Ball Shippuden, because again, very believable, great story. They added a brand new character that is essentially a female illusion version of Goku, and it's just really, really interesting. And the reason I'm saying that Toyotaro has seen this before is, for one, Toyotaro started out as a Dragon Ball fan manga creator, so I'm sure that he is part of the Dragon Ball fan manga scene, has seen a lot of the stuff from the Dragon Ball fan manga side of things, and knows exactly what this story is about. But also, I do think that there was a huge inspiration to how Goku defeated Moro that came from the Naruto side of things, that came from Naruto itself. Obviously, everyone has already made this joke that the astral projection version of Goku at the end of the Moro arc looks exactly like Susanoo, which is an Uchiha ability that essentially wraps yourself in this ginormous astral entity that is covered in chakra, and you can use it to basically have huge kaiju fights. Essentially, that's the real reason they were created, because we already seen kaiju fights in the original Naruto when Naruto faced Gaara. So I'm assuming that they were like, you know what, let's make it so we have the mech version of ninjas, essentially, like chakra mechs. And that's exactly what happened with Naruto and Sasuke and a lot of the Uchiha clan. Naruto can't do it the same way. It's not Susanoo, but it's essentially the same thing. It's the chakra of the nine-tailed fox surrounding him. So I would say that Goku's transformation at the end is more akin to Naruto's transformation than it is to a Susanoo, but it still has the same physical properties. Essentially, the astral projection could touch everything physical and push it away, and essentially the user is at the forehead of the astral projection and can leave whenever they want. And that's exactly what happens at the end of the Moro arc, where Goku gets all the key from all his friends by Router Vegeta, and then Router Vegeta gives it to him, transforming him into Ultra, or Mastered Ultra Instinct, giving him so much ki to the point that he actually goes into this form. I think probably because Ub gave him some of that ki, some of that Kai godly ki, and then yeah, he transformed just like that. So that ability was able to push the Moro, Earth Moro, away from him, push him apart, and that way Goku can get his bearings and go in for the kill, essentially breaking the crystal in the middle of Moro's head. So my opinion on this is that I definitely like taking inspiration from other mangas and other anime when it comes to Dragon Ball. Dragon Ball could be really put in a category where it's all really just beat 'em up, shooting ki blasts, and that is it. Essentially some of the really basic and boring moves that we've seen in Dragon Ball Z, Budokai Tenkaichi, any of them, any of the ki volleys, or just punching, swerving around, punching again, and then going into like a manual charge. Yeah, it's essentially that's what people kind of liken Dragon Ball to be. But that is the reason that I love Dragon Ball fan manga so much, because they always think outside the box when it comes to exactly what kind of fights that we're going to be seeing in the story. And the abilities, usually some of the best stories have really interesting versions of fights and interesting abilities that these characters implement, and they don't always hit the mark. I mean, young Gigi is by far the most criminal in this. He follows the Dragon Ball formula to a T, with transformations going back and forth, the fighting, all that stuff. It's essentially just Dragon Ball Z's version of fights. And I feel like with how much shit Dragon Ball Super actually gets, it has gone completely out of its way to make itself a lot more different than anything that we've seen before when it comes to the actual fights. Not only the series, but especially Dragon Ball Super Broly and the story when it came to that, with Gogeta's moves, Broly's moves, a lot of the fighting is martial arts or brawling, boxing, grappling, UFC style fighting, and moves you can actually recognize. And the abilities themselves are really integral and different, especially the ones coming from Gogeta in that movie. But there are a lot of different variations, especially in the Tournament of Power, of different abilities that we've seen, and that is something that I have to praise Dragon Ball Super in. And Dragon Ball Super's manga does it even better, and this is a version of that where, yeah, it does do it a lot better. The astral projection Goku is really cool. There is some artwork out there, and I'm not trying to slam anybody. I'm not trying to slam the artist, because the artwork is quite gorgeous. You guys can see it right here. I'm going to leave a link to it in the description below, and it is beautifully done. It is gorgeous. Moro looks sickening, like he should at the end, because he's basically an abomination at the end. But this is really cool because it just shows some of the versions of the way that this fight could have gone. But more importantly, it also shows one of the weaknesses of Dragon Ball, and that is relying on everything that we've seen before. Dragon Ball Super's Moro arc does that again, with having everyone's ki basically make a spirit bomb and destroy the character through Ultra Instinct. That's essentially what it does, and it's really, 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 really boring. So when it comes to this artwork, we essentially see Goku doing a dragon fist and killing Moro that way. And although that is cool, that is really cool, it's just been there, done that. It's been done before several times now. And I like seeing new things. I like the fact that Goku broke the crystal and that is how he destroyed him. I don't like how he got to that point with the whole everyone makes a spirit bomb thing. But again, ultimately, it is done very well. And I definitely like the direction they went. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching the video up to this point. I am on vacation, so no hashtag end of video squad today, but I will have some more tomorrow. You guys are the fucking squad. This is going to be Blackscape signing off. Take care, guys.
Subscribe for more content.